ओके, माय स्क्रीन इज विजिबल। I hope my screen is visible. Reply something, yes, no. Okay, so basically we have covered the last lecture, evidence for usefulness of OMD, which is why we should go for object-oriented analysis and designing. What are the advantages that we are getting when we are going for OAD? So where we have discussed some advantages like OMD, that is object-oriented modeling, are used to document the program that are all ill-structured and difficult to understand. But implementation of this OO will help us to understand. This approach is successfully taught to others and use it to communicate with application experts. Then we have discussed one more advantage, that is object-oriented technology is expanded and may be used in many applications, starting from General Electric to companies throughout the world in various aspects. So not only the development part, but designing part that could be understood to understand the difficulty of a problem in a simplest manner. So nowadays it is a part of computer science and software engineering mainstream. So in brief, we can say that applications of Generic Electric Research and Development Center has proved that if we are going with object-oriented analysis and designing, will definitely lead to the success of the project. Object-oriented technology, that is what this OOPS techniques for developing the compiler, graphics, user interfaces, database, and object-oriented languages. Then we have discussed its applications starting from small program to all the applications of software engineering mainstream. Then object-oriented programming system language applications in various conferences like European, then IEEE computer and communication, so ACM. This part what we discussed into the previous lectures. Now we have started again with the modeling concept, but what actually the modeling is? Modeling is nothing but abstraction of something for the purpose of understanding it before building it. So to understand the modeling, we have discussed one simple example of mobile phone. So if you are in a show that what we can say shop, and you are asking the say that shopkeeper to show the mobile, he will show you some kind of a dummy model, will not show you the actual model. He will show you the dummy model. You have to understand it, you have to explore it, what are the features probable will be there. And once you agreed that you are going to purchase that particular model, then and then only he will open the new piece, or else you will see the entire part with the dummy model. So that dummy model is nothing but is a kind of a representation of your actual system. Before going for actual system, to make the system understandable to everyone, you prepare some kind of a demos. So preparation of that demo model is nothing, that demo part is nothing but we can say simply as a modeling. And that can be done just in a simplest abstract manner. So we can say that in preparing the model, we can have two dimensions. One, a view of a system that may be a static or may be a dynamic. And second, stage of development. So depending on type of development life cycle, we can have the particular model. So why we should go for the modeling, or what there may be a possible question then, what are the advantages of modeling? So simply is what we can remember is modeling will help us before going for actual development. Modeling will help us to understand that how my final product will look like. Simply, it will have some kind of a demonstration. So in demonstration part, you can complete the testing scenario. So testing also can be done easily when you have a modeling part with you. As product, some demo product is with you, so that will help you to have one-to-one interaction with your customer, and also the end user, the customer also will be able to know how my final product will be looking, which help us for understanding in visualization. So my clear cut project idea will be there. Another simple way to understand the purpose preparing the modeling is that civil engineer, before going for actual construction, he prepares the bungalow in blueprints. The development of blueprints is nothing but modeling concept. जो बंगला त्या सिव्हिल इंजिनिअरला बांधायचा आहे तो पूर्ण बंगला बांधायच्या आधी तो काय करतो, वेगवेगळ्या अँगलमधून बंगला कसा दिसेल याचे काही व्ह्यू तयार करतो. तो त्याला आपण म्हणतो ते आपण ब्लूप्रिंट्समध्ये पाहू शकतो. ते ब्लूप्रिंट्स पाहून एंड युजरला आयडिया क्लिअर होती की माझा बंगला कसा असेल, मग बंगल्यामध्ये काही चेंजेस करायचे असतील ते आधी कन्स्ट्रक्शन पूर्ण म्हणजे चालू करायच्या आधीच तो त्या व्ह्यूमध्ये बघून सांगू शकतो, विच इज नथिंग बट व्हिज्युअलायझेशन. आणि फायनल बंगला कसा असेल ह्याचा एक शॉर्ट मध्ये आपल्याला थोडी आयडिया येऊ शकते. फर्दर काही प्रॉब्लेम्स असतील तर ते आपण त्या मॉडेलमधूनच ते रिमूव्ह करू शकतो. दॅट इज व्हॉट रिडक्शन ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी. दिस इज व्हॉट द डिफरंट ऍडव्हान्टेजेस वी आर गेटिंग व्हेन वी आर गोइंग फॉर मॉडेलिंग पार्ट. दॅट पार्ट वी हॅव डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रिव्हियस सेशन्स. नाऊ वी आर स्टार्टिंग विथ द नेक्स्ट, दॅट वाय ऑर व्हॉट आर द ऍडव्हान्टेजेस ऑफ मॉडेलिंग, पर्पज ऑफ द मॉडेलिंग. After that, list and explain different types of models. So that different models we will discuss based on some dimensions. So there may be possibility of the two dimensions. The first is a view, how you are going to look towards the system. And second, at what stage of the development that particular model is. Based on that, we can have a different models. So simply remember, the first part is object model. Second part as a dynamic model. And third part as functional model. So with respect to this, we can say that what is object model? So object model is nothing but describe basic structure of object and their relationship. So object is nothing but what? The smallest part or part of your project. In maybe whatever the part, we are going to define that part as a object. So that once you could able to define the object, with respect to object, we can decide the four characteristics. That is, the object must be having state, object must be having some kind of a behavior, and object must be having some kind of unique identity. And next point is, object must be having some kind of relationship responsibilities. So that each and every project, whatever we are going to discuss, that project is nothing but collection of different objects. So with reference to that objects, how the objects of that particular project will able to interact with each other. So suppose one object having the similar kind of properties with the other object. So such all objects will combine together. We will call them as a class. And once we have a class, we can go with four pillars of object-oriented programming language. That is abstraction, encapsulation, modularity, and hierarchy. So based on that, we can develop the entire project directly. So smallest part of entire project that we are going to represent in terms of object. So object is nothing but what we can say, the basic structure. And how that elements are going to interact with each other, that we are going to represent. So simply remember, if you are able to see my screen, how we are going to represent object, a simple rectangle. I'm just showing you here. This is what an object. Right here, object name. Colon. So object will don't have an existence because object is nothing but an entity of, derived entity of class. So we have to give the name to the class also. So object name and class, a simple rectangle, that part represents a simple object. So this is simple object, I can say here. This is a simple text and I'm writing here. I'll put that part as a here. See, a simple rectangle is a representation to represent object. and whatever the notations I'm using, that notations are taken from UML side, that is Unified Modeling Language. That what is UML, what are the different notations are there, that part we will discuss in upcoming slides. But at this moment, just represent, just understand, I'm going to use simple rectangle to represent the object and how the objects will interact with each other. So all objects will be represented in this simple rectangle, and their communication, their relationship will be represented in terms of association. That association, nothing but simple smallest type of relationship, basic relationship, with the help of some arcs. That part we will discuss. So object model represents communication among the different objects that are involved in particular functionality. So that part we will represent, and it is known as object diagram also. So captures static structure of the system, no doubt. Objects in the systems having some kind of a properties. So we are calling them as an attribute. So attributes are nothing but named properties of the class, that particular object. Operations, it represent how your object acts and reacts. Because if you are remembering, we said that every object possesses the four characteristics. What are that four characteristics? SBIR, which stands for state, behavior, identity. That identity we are saying as an unique identity, and roles and responsibility. So that state represents simply how the object you are acts and that state represents your present condition. So if I take an example of an object as a car, and car of that particular color of that particular car, red, that indicates state. Then behavior, how your object is going to act. Like if your car, considering object car, it is going in a straight forward line. That is what forward directions. It's moving in forward directions, moving in reverse directions. Behavior, that speed has been get changed, gear has been get changed. That is what represents behavior, how your object acts and reacts. Then identity, we can say each and every object must be having unique identity. So in case of my car, I can say that it is having a unique number. That is what we are getting from RTO, that RTO registration number. So throughout, if you go to any state, based on that state, RTO system is there. That RTO office assigns a unique identity to that particular car. And if you take that car from one state to another state, there may be a possibility that you can continue with your own old number also, or you can take another passing from that particular state. That is up to you, because if you are going to do passing over there, again you need to go for some kind of a properties implementation, like you have to pay tax from their region also. So based on that, cut what we can say in kind of an inheritance, taking objectives from one class to another class, maybe from its parent class to child class, or it may be a possibility again to go back, or multiple inheritance or multi-level inheritance. Based on that, properties of the class, properties of an objects are going to get changed. But make sure that identity remains same. So that we are calling as what? Object modeling. So another special definition, in simplest manner we can say what actually the object is. So it defines as a conceptual part, maybe an abstract or thing with purposeful meaning. Two purposes of the objects: promote understanding of the real world. So we can take the object from real world, or it may be a practical basis for computer implementation. So all objects must have identity and are distinguishable. So this is another example. You can just check it out. I hope this screen is visible. So first part represents state of the particular object. Second is behavior, taking action from this side to this side. Unique identity, whatever the parts I have, so many different objects are there, but each object having unique identity so that I can easily recognize it. Is this clear? Is this clear to all? We are discussing about the object modeling. Okay. Now, once we are clear with the concept of object, we can go for the next concept that is called as one class. So what is class? Class is nothing but, we can simply remember, class is nothing but group of similar objects. So it provides formal graphic notation for modeling the object, class, and their relationship to one another. So object class describes group of objects with similar properties. That similar properties I am calling as an attributes, or maybe some common behavior, that is called as operation, or maybe because of some common relationship, that is what responsibilities to other objects and common semantics. So object of class share a common semantic purposes. We are calling them as a class. Simply remember this definition, a very, very important part. So an object class describes group of objects with similar properties. I'll make it more clear. That is, an class describes group of objects with similar properties, that is attributes, or maybe common behavior, or maybe having common relationships to other objects and common semantics. So we will call them as what? Class. How to represent object in UML? Simple rectangle. Now, how to represent the class? Rectangle with three compartments. That part we will discuss. Now, once you could able to identify the objects that can be represented in simple manner, which will help us to understand the graphical notations. I'm calling them as simple graphical notations for modeling the object, class, and their relationship. They are useful for both abstract modeling and designing. So in that case, we can take the help of one simple scenario that we will discuss. For example, let us consider here. This is what my class representation. How to represent the class? Class is represented in simple rectangle having three compartments, means three parts. So first compartment tells us about the class name. Second compartment tells us about the attributes, and third compartment tells us about the operations. So class name, attribute, and operations. So example we can see here, just one more slide to understand how to represent the class. Okay, I'll show you. I'll consider once to class. Let us consider class as a car. Name of class as a car. Attributes. Attributes represent simple state. So maybe color is a red. Operations, I can say. Operations maybe always we can represent in terms of private properties, maybe moving forward. So we can say fast, maybe private as slow, like this. So we can represent simple class here, rectangle with three compartments, or even we can take the help of this object called as what a person can be represented as a class. So simply same name we can say person, attributes, name of that person, operations, what the role that person is going to perform, how that particular object is going to act and react. That part we will describe as in terms of class diagrams. Next, instance diagram, that part we can say as a part of the again particular class, because we are considering it as in terms of set of objects. So it describes how particular set of object relate to each others. It describes again the objects. So if I consider one as a class called as what a person, so that person maybe having the different names. For example, I have given here as a Ram, Jay, you can understand. So we are calling them as, these are nothing but instance of the diagram, means instance of that particular class represented with this arrow. What is attribute? Attributes are nothing but named properties of the class. It is a data value held by object in that particular class. So each attribute name is unique within a class. So attribute should be a pure data value, but it should not be in a particular object. Attributes are listed in the second part of the class. So class is having three compartment. So second compartment will be covered with attributes. Each attribute name may followed by optional details such as type and default type, like their whether the private, public, default. So the type is preceded by the colons. So what kind of properties it is having, whether it is a private, public or default. Based on that, we can assign its values. So that is, we are calling as one attribute. So what is attribute? Attributes nothing but named properties of a class having a pure value that is represented in terms as data value held by the objects. Again, with reference to that, attributes also must be having uniqueness within that particular class. So remember this one of the properties. So this is what my simple class named as a person. Second, attribute. So attribute name I am giving here. Attribute name I am giving here. Just read it. So name, string, integer. So class with attributes. One attribute, person class, name, Ram, having age 24. So this is what one of the important attribute of the class. Second, after attribute, the second part of the class is called as what? Operations, or simply it is referred as methods also. In some cases, we are calling it as a behavior also. So operations, methods, behavior, all are same. So operation is a function or transformation that may be applied to or by object in a particular class. All objects in the class share the same operations. The same operation may apply to many different classes also. Such an operation is polymorphic. That is the same operations on different forms in different classes. Method is the implementation of an operation for a particular class. See here, example of operations. Operations are listed in the lower third of the class, third compartment. This is class. हा माझा काय आहे? Class आहे. हा class किती part मध्ये divide करतो आपण? तीन part मध्ये divide करतो आहे. पहिला पार्ट काय सांगतोय तुमचा क्लास नेम, दुसरा पार्ट काय सांगतोय बघा इथे लक्षात येईल तुम्हाला. सो फर्स्ट पार्ट इज टेलिंग अस द सिंपल क्लास नेम. जस्ट पे अटेंशन हियर, दिस इज क्लास नेम. सेकंड कंपार्टमेंट इज टेलिंग अबाउट ओनली ऍट्रिब्यूट्स. इट इज टेलिंग अबाउट ओनली ऍट्रिब्यूट्स. And third compartment is telling about only operations, methods, behaviors, operations. This is what simple representation of class. Class name, attribute, operation. Attribute nothing but what we said so far. These are nothing but named properties of the class. Attributes may be represented as plus, minus. That plus is private. Minus means we can say public, and by default with symbol of simple colon. Now we are discussing about the third compartment. It is called as what? Operations. Operations, sometimes it is referred as a behavior, how your object is act and reacts. Sometimes it is referred as a methods also. So for example, a particular file, example, if I say file may have an operation like print. Different method could be implemented to print, like ASCII files, binary files, etc. So we can add this as a part of their class. So remember this class name, if I say as an car, attributes, properties of that car, and operations, what are the functionalities that particular car is going to do. So you can note down this. Next part is what? Association. So simple, here we will work with association, because the dictionary meaning of this link and association, if we consider, it is same. But is there any difference between link and association? These all are related with a relationship, because in object diagram we will consider objects. After consideration of an object, we will club similar objects into a class. Once we have a class, we need to define the relationship among the class, because after consideration of a classes, if we put the classes together based on their properties or based on some common semantics, we need to decide their package structure. And based on the packages, the different packages are associated with each others depending on type of implementations you are allowing. So that package relationship will be represented in terms of association. So in software engineering, you might have studied the relationship among the different modules, maybe cohesion, coupling, that is in terms of dependency, or higher the coupling, higher the calling, again the type of what we can say, the way, the style you are going to implement. So to understand it, we will discuss the basic idea about the links and association. So simply remember, link and association are the means for establishing relationship among the objects and the classes. जेव्हा आपण काही ऑब्जेक्ट्स रिप्रेझेंट करतोय आपल्या अंडरस्टँडिंगसाठी, त्यावेळेस त्या ऑब्जेक्टमध्ये काहीतरी रिलेशन आहे, म्हणजे काहीतरी डेटा एक्सचेंज होतोय, इन्फॉर्मेशन फ्लो होते फ्रॉम वन ऑब्जेक्ट्स टू अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट्स, और मे बी इन अ रिव्हर्स केस ऑल्सो. जो काही ऑब्जेक्ट फ्लो होणार आहे किंवा जो काही डेटा फ्लो होणार आहे फ्रॉम वन एंटिटी टू अनदर एंटिटी, that flow will be represented either in terms of links or in terms of association. So what is link? Link is a physical or conceptual connection between objects. So simply I can say that link is an instance of an association. Link shows relationship between two or more objects. Now what is association? Because link I have described in terms of association. Now what is association? Because in UML language, link part we will remember as an association only. So association describes group of links with common structure and semantics. So all the links in an association connection objects from the same class. Association and links often appears as a verbs in a problem statement. So association describes set of potential links in the same way that the class describes a set of potential objects. So simply we can say that associations are bidirectional. So in real, both the directions of traversal are equally meaningful and refers to same association. Association are often implemented in programming language as pointers from one object to another object. So in perspective of developer's side, you can remember this definition. Now just kindly recall this. I will explain it one more time. We are discussing about the links and association. We'll see one more diagram and then we will come back to this slide. Okay. So on your screen, I'm just showing you one sample class diagram. So how to represent the class? This is a rectangle. This is a rectangle having three parts. First as a customer, second attributes. What are the attributes? Name, location. Then third part as an operation. So what that customer is going to give? Send order, receive order, like this. The next object is called as what? Orders. Attributes like date, number. Order may be conferred or order may be closed. So I will consider this as a main class. So I'll call it as what? Super class. Then there is a relationship between customer and order. So one customer may give n number of orders. So this is associated, simple straight line. There is no arrow that indicates bidirectional association. So we will call this in UML, we will call this as association. But in case of developer's perspective, we will call it as what? Link. Because these two classes are associated. Because these two classes are linked to each others when I'm developing sides perspective. So simply remember this part. How to draw this diagram, how to define the different types of relationship, that we will discuss upcoming part. मला काय करायचे बघा, हे दोन क्लासेस आहेत आता माझ्याकडे. कुठला? एक कस्टमर क्लास आहे आणि दुसरा ऑर्डर क्लास आहे. त्या दोन मध्ये काय रिलेशनशिप आहे, हे रिलेशन मी कसं दाखवलंय? त्या सिंपल स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड लाईनने. इथे कुठेही एरो नाही. एरो दाखवायचा असेल तर आपण कसं दाखवू शकतो? फॉर एक्झाम्पल हा इथून असा इथे एरो येतो तुम्हाला. हे जर तुम्ही पाहिलं असेल, यू कॅन जस्ट चेक इट आउट दिस. इथं एरो दिसतोय म्हणजे हे एकाच डायरेक्शननी फ्लो होत आहे. ह्याला म्हणतात युनिडायरेक्शनल. ज्यावेळेस एरो नाही त्याचा अर्थ काय होतो? बाय डायरेक्शनल. सिम्पली रिमेंबर, हे आपल्याला डिस्कस करायचं आहे. ह्याला म्हणतात असोसिएशन. मग आता लिंक आणि असोसिएशन सेम आहे का? तर मी आत्ता सांगेन तुम्हाला. ऍक्च्युली डिफरन्स आहे तिथं, पण आत्ता आपल्याला फक्त समजण्यासाठी लक्षात ठेवा, लिंक अँड असोसिएशन बोथ आर सेम. काय डिफरन्स आहे एक्झॅक्टली मी जे तुम्हाला सांगितलं? की हे रिलेट कुठं होतंय, ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही डिझायनर्स पर्स्पेक्टिव्ह सोडून डेव्हलपर्स पर्स्पेक्टिव्हला जाता आणि त्यावेळेस तुम्हाला काही प्रॉपर्टीज सेट करायच्या असतात, त्या प्रॉपर्टीज सेट करताना तुम्ही काय वापरताय, लिंक कन्सेप्ट वापरताय. पण फक्त डेव्हलपर साईडला हा लिंक कन्सेप्ट येतो, पण ज्यावेळेस तुम्ही डिझायनर्स पर्स्पेक्टिव्हने विचार करताय एखाद्या प्रॉब्लेमवर, एखाद्या प्रोजेक्टवर, त्यावेळेस आपण कुठला वर्ड बेसिकली यूज करणार आहोत, वी विल यूज अ सिम्पल असोसिएशन वर्ड. म्हणजे लक्षात ठेवा, इथून पुढे असोसिएशन म्हणजे काय, तर सगळ्यात बेसिक टाईप ऑफ रिलेशनशिप. कशासाठी, तुमच्या जे काही दोन एंटिटीज आहेत, आता आपल्याकडे दोन एंटिटीज कुठल्या कुठल्या, हा एक क्लास आहे, हा एक क्लास आहे. कदाचित तुम्हाला क्लास आणि ऑब्जेक्ट मध्ये पण रिलेशनशिप दाखवायचं असेल, तर त्यावेळेस सुद्धा आपण, आणि माहित नाही कुठल्या लेवलचं असेल, त्यावेळेस आपण बेसिक रिलेशनशिप कुठून स्टार्ट करतोय त्यांच्यामध्ये, तर ती स्टार्ट करतोय आपण सिम्पल असोसिएशन फॉर्मॅट मध्ये. सो असोसिएशन इज नथिंग बट सिम्पली रिमेंबर, हवं असेल तर कुठे तर लिहून घ्या, असोसिएशन इज नथिंग बट सिम्पल सिमेंटिक रिलेशनशिप अमंग द एंटिटीज, we will call it as one association. Simple semantic relationship among the entities, we will call it as one association. Now what is link? Link is nothing but simple again association. Link is nothing but simply again association. Now, what are the different types of association, how to represent it, that now we are discussing. Now, association I am discussing. So, association, simply remember, is nothing but simple semantic relationship. I'll add here. Association is nothing but simple semantic relationship among entities. Remember this definition. I hope you are clear with association. Now how to represent the association? To represent the association, we are going to use different notations. So association may be represented as simple line. We can say here, this as a simple line. There is no arrow. It is called as one bidirectional association. And if there is an arrow, we will call it as one unidirectional association. I hope you are getting. Please reply. दिसतंय मी स्लाइडवर काय चेंजेस करतोय ते, रिप्लाय करा काहीतरी. ओके, थँक्यू थँक्यू पूजा, थँक्यू. आता आपण काय डिस्कस करतोय, व्हॉट इज असोसिएशन. असोसिएशन म्हणजे मी काय सांगितलं, इट इज नथिंग बट सिम्पल सिमेंटिक रिलेशनशिप. जे काही आपण ऑब्जेक्ट्स असतील, जे काही क्लासेस असतील, ते आपण क्लास एकत्र केले. आता क्लास एका ठिकाणी आणल्यानंतर आपल्याला काय करायचं आहे, त्यामध्ये काहीतरी रिलेशनशिप दाखवायचं आपल्याला, काहीतरी त्यांच्यामध्ये डेटा फ्लो होत असेल किंवा काही प्रॉपर्टीज कंबाईन होत असतील आणि त्यांच्यामध्ये काही रिलेशन क्रिएट होत असेल, तर ते रिलेशन ज्या बेसिक रिलेशनशिपने आपण दाखवतोय त्या रिलेशनशिपला आपण काय म्हणतोय, असोसिएशन. मग असोसिएशन रिप्रेझेंट कसं करायचं, जसं मी तुम्हाला सांगितलं की ऑब्जेक्ट रिप्रेझेंट करायला आपण काय वापरणार आहे, सिम्पल रेक्टॅंगल. क्लास रिप्रेझेंट करायला आपण काय वापरणार आहे, रेक्टॅंगल विथ थ्री कंपार्टमेंट. कंपार्टमेंट म्हणजे लक्षात ठेवा पार्ट्स. पहिला पार्ट काय सांगेल तुम्हाला, त्या क्लासचं नाव. दुसरा पार्ट काय सांगेल, त्याचे ऍट्रिब्यूट्स. तिसरा पार्ट काय सांगेल तुम्हाला, त्याचे ऑपरेशन्स, मेथड्स अँड ऑर बिहेवियर. मग आता ज्यावेळेस आपण असे सगळे ऑब्जेक्ट्स कंबाईन केले, सगळे क्लासेस कंबाईन केले, आता फॉर एक्झाम्पल ह्या डायग्राम मध्ये तुम्हाला चार क्लासेस एका डायग्राम मध्ये दिसतात. आता ह्या क्लासमध्ये मला काहीतरी रिलेशनशिप दाखवायचं आहे. आता इथं सिम्पल लाईन आहे, ज्याला आपण काय म्हणतोय, सिम्पल सिमेंटिक रिलेशनशिप असोसिएशन. इथं काय दिसतंय तुम्हाला, एक लाईन, आणि इथं तुम्हाला काय दिसतंय, ट्रायंगल. ह्याला म्हणतात जनरलायझेशन रिलेशनशिप. जनरलायझेशन रिलेशनशिप म्हणजे आता कशी दाखवतोय आपण रिलेशनशिप बघा. हा माझा ऑर्डर पॅरेंट क्लास आहे आणि त्याचे दोन चाइल्ड क्लास आहेत, एक स्पेशल ऑर्डर आहे आणि एक नॉर्मल ऑर्डर आहे. मग स्पेशल ऑर्डर आणि ऑर्डर मधलं रिलेशनशिप मी काय दाखवते, मेंटेनिंग पॅरंट चाइल्ड रिलेशनशिप. हे काय झालं, हा पण असोसिएशनचा टाइप आहे, पण कुठल्या असोसिएशनचा टाइप आहे, हा जनरलायझेशन. आय होप यू आर गेटिंग व्हॉट आय वॉन्ट टू से. ज्यावेळेस कुठलाही एरो नाही त्यावेळेस त्याला आपण काय म्हणतोय, सिम्पल सिमेंटिक बाय डायरेक्शनल. आणि ज्यावेळेस एरो आहे त्यावेळेस आपण काय म्हणू त्याला, युनिडायरेक्शनल. सो आय विल जस्ट बाय डायरेक्शनल आणि याला म्हणतो मी युनिडायरेक्शनल असोसिएशन. This is bi-directional. Unidirectional. Hey, unidirectional इकडून इकडे असू शकतं किंवा तुम्ही इकडून इकडे पण काढू शकता, like this. एरोची डिरेक्शन ज्या साईडला जाईल याचा अर्थ काय होतो, इकडून डेटा इकडं फ्लो होत आहे, इकडून डेटा इकडं फ्लो होत आहे. आणि ज्यावेळेस कुठलाही एरोची डिरेक्शन नाही म्हणजे काय, डेटा इकडून पण इकडं जाऊ शकतो, इकडून पण, जस्ट लाईक युअर हाफ डुप्लेक्स अँड फुल डुप्लेक्स दॅट यू हॅव स्टडीड इन कम्प्युटर नेटवर्क. सो आय एम कॉलिंग इट एज व्हॉट, सिम्पल असोसिएशन. हे लक्षात आलं का सगळ्यांच्या, एनी डाऊट देअर? ज्यावेळेस मी आता असोसिएशन समजलं, मला असोसिएशन म्हणजे काय म्हणायचं, सिम्पल सिमेंटिक रिलेशनशिप. आता ह्याचे काही टाइप्स असू शकतात का? हो, त्याचे टाइप्स असू शकतात. कुठले कुठले? वन टू वन असोसिएशन और मेनी टू वन असोसिएशन और टर्नरी असोसिएशन. टर्नरी मीन्स मोर देन टू, थ्री एंटिटीज वी कॅन से, लाईक टर्नरी असोसिएशन. आता त्याचे काही एक्झाम्पल्स आपण बघूया. See here. This is one class diagram, simple. I have simple represented, has a capital, country has a capital with an instance diagram. हे त्याचे इन्स्टंट्स आहेत, हे तुम्ही चेक करू शकता. हे काय आलं, वन टू वन असोसिएशन म्हणजे एकच कॅपिटल असणार आहे. फॉर एक्झाम्पल, इफ आय कन्सिडर एज अन इंडिया as a country has a capital Delhi, will be represented one simple diagram, one to one association. Is this clear? One to one association. Now next, see here, many to many association. See here, many to many association. Line, actually line, how the line is made up of different points. So many points are connected to each other to form a lines. Or you can say that one point, two point, point from one point to another point. So minimum you can say that two points. I have just added over there just to understand. So many to many association, you can just check it out, this how to represent the relationship among point and line. So we just connect the points, different points, to form the line. So that is again many to many. So one point may be associated with more than one lines also, or one line may be having more than one points also. So that is what we are representing, many to many association. Now this is ternary association. Ternary means more than three entities. or more than two entities, rather we can say that two different types of entities we are considering together, we will call it as what? Ternary association. So for example, here I am considering project as one entity, different resources working on that project, I am considering them one of the resources as a person. Third entity I am considering as a language, which programming language they are going to use. So this is more than two different entities represented in one diagram, I am calling that as a ternary association. Again, same example, different project associated with each other. So it represents instance also. Instance means example. So what we are saying, we are discussing association, definition of the association. Association is nothing but simple semantic relationship among the different entities. Simple solid line. No arrow, bidirectional, with arrow, unidirectional. Association has different types. So these are the types of association: one-to-one association, many-to-many association, and ternary association. Even we can consider here as a multiplicity. Multiplicity will tell us the exact count. That part we will discuss. So this is the first one, one-to-one association. Second, many-to-many association. In case of one-to-one, remember country and capital. In case of many-to-many, remember point and line. And in case of ternary association, remember one project. For that particular project, different persons are working with different languages. I'm talking about programming languages, or maybe you consider as a different domains also. So this is CAD project, MIS project, one person working with different languages. This is ternary association. Now we can represent exact association with specified number. For example, if I say your class TY BTech semester 1 division A, how many strength of the class if I consider? Almost 70. So that 70 exactly specify the strength of your class. So similarly, I want to represent the association, but how many entities associated with each other? That entities I want to know, I want to check. So that part you can discuss here simply in terms of one more type of relationship called as what? Multiplicity. So here, multiplicity we are going to indicate. So it specifies how many instances. Remember this. It specifies how many instances of one class may relate to single instance of an associated class. Multiplicity. Multiplicity means exact number, exact count आपल्याला सांगायचं आहे. म्हणजे आता काय सांगितलं मी तुम्हाला की क्लास, त्या क्लास मध्ये एक्झॅक्ट किती ऑब्जेक्ट्स आहेत, तसं त्या ऑब्जेक्ट्स मधल्या दुसरा कुठला आपण एंटिटी कन्सिडर करत असेल तर त्यामध्ये काय रिलेशनशिप आहे एक्झॅक्टली आपण काउंट मध्ये सांगतोय, त्याला आपण काय म्हणतोय? मल्टिप्लिसिटी. बघा, त्याचं एक एक्झाम्पल दिलंय. ही फाईल आहे, ऍक्सेस कोण करू शकतो? युजर्स. N number of users can access this. So this describes their exact counts. That will be represented in terms of multiplicity. Mala ajun ek example sangto multiplicity cha. How to represent the multiplicity? Association. I'm just representing one class named as a company and one more class as an employee. So their relationship, I have represented simple association, straightforward line. No arrow, bidirectional association. So here that number represents multiplicity. So one means exactly one. So one entity of this company class associated with exactly one entity of employee class. So that I will call as a exactly one. If there 1.00 means, sorry, 1..*, it may represent one or many. So company may have one or many employees. Getting? But employee will have exactly one company. एक कामगार एका वेळी एकाच कंपनीत काम करू शकतो, पण एका कंपनी मध्ये ऍट अ टाइम एकापेक्षा जास्त कामगार असू शकतात. हे एक्झॅक्टली काउंट आपण रिप्रेझेंट करतो, म्हणजे किती एंटिटीज दुसऱ्या एंटिटी म्हणजे दुसऱ्या एम्प्लॉयरच्या ह्याच्यामध्ये किती असोसिएटेड आहेत, हे जे रिलेशन आपण एक्झॅक्टली काउंट मध्ये सांगतो त्याला आपण काय म्हणतोय, मल्टिप्लिसिटी. आय होप दिस पार्ट इज क्लिअर. त्याचं अजून एक एक्झाम्पल त्यांनी दिलेलं आहे. Okay, is this part clear? Reply something, yes, no. Okay, now we will take a pause here. Just give me your attendance first. Give me attendance. One, roll number one.
Event.
Two. Three.
Present, sir.
Four.
Four present, sir.
Five. Roll number five. Six.
Present.
Seven. You fast. Be fast. Seven absent. Okay. Eight.
Present.
Nine. Ten. Roll number ten.